A quick announcement for if you want to take your trading to the next level. I recently started a profitable trading signal group in which I show you and I send signals of all of my trades. If you want to join this group or if you're interested in that, go check out the first link down in the description or in the pinned comment. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to Salinix Crypto and welcome to a new video in which I wanted to do a quick review, quick analysis and quick overview of Anchor, which as you can see in the last 2 hours it is, has spiked up a lot. It has spiked up by, I think at the top, like 70-80%. Yeah, well, precisely. It's now up 50% from where we were 24 hours ago. But the volume is amazing. It's almost at 600 million. And if you take a look at the volume, you can see that there's a lot of Korean volume coming in, which usually I would then say, all right, it's manipulated. But don't worry, I know that most of you know, I know it as well. Anchor has had some amazing and huge news. Anchor is working together with Microsoft. They've partnered up with Microsoft to support enterprises and organizations needing access to blockchain data with a reliable, easy to use node hosting service. So amazing news. Microsoft is obviously one of the biggest Web2 companies out there still to this day. And them working together. Whatever the product is, I mean, the product sounds amazing, but let's be honest, whatever the product is, this is amazing for Anchor in intrinsic value. But apart from that, it's also amazing for the price. However, it does leave us with some questions about especially the price, I think. And I wanted to try to answer those in this video. Like, the main thing is with news like this is that even though, as I said, I really do think it increases the long term, but also the short term intrinsic value of Anchor as a product. And project, and therefore also Anchor as a token. But on the short term, usually news like this, it's amazing, and we could actually rally further, but it's also a little bit that, all right, we've had the news, then that's it. That happens a lot as well. So there are certain things we need to do in terms of price movements in order for us to confirm that we can move higher. Like right now, we did hit a major resistance level between 5.2 and 5.6 cents. If you take a look at the daily time frame, for example, you can see that that also was our top, the 11th of August, when we also had some bullish momentum in this in this bearish market. Let me see if this light is better. Excuse me. Oh, that's definitely not better. But all right, so it's a strong resistance level. You can also see that from the history back when we still were in some sort of a bull market. So the big question is can we get higher than that? And even though that is the big question, the most important level is actually right here at around 4.8 and 4.7 cents. All right, the thing is that this candle closes in about 15 minutes. So probably when you're watching this video, the candle has already closed. If we're able to, I mean, the first thing we have to do is close above 4.7 cents. All right, and I think we are actually able to do that. If we're not, then we're just going to drop down to 4.4 and down to 4 cents. And then from there, we'll see again if we can get a second rally. But then we're not breaking 5.2 and 5.5 cents. But I assume that we are going to break above that. And then the big thing is can we hold it as a support? So again, 4.7, 4.9. Let's keep it at that level. If we can actually hold that as a support and then break above 5.2, not the level we reach around 5.6, it's really 5.2, 5.3, that's the strongest level. So if we can then break above 5.3 from that support at 4.7, 4.8 cents, I'm talking about cents all the time, of course, then I think we can continue it. So yes, we can continue this rally. It's amazing news. But first of all, we need to hold 4.7 cents, and then we need to get a bullish breakout at least above 5.2 cents. And if we do that, we can actually move up by another, I think, 30-25%. I really don't have a most likely scenario, to be honest. Sorry for that, but it's just the way it is, right? And with news like this, it would be foolish of me, I think, to have a really set in stone opinion. So on the other hand, even though I think we will be able to break above 4.7, 4.9 cents, if we are not able to break above 5.2 or 5.3 cents within like 2-3 days, then we will probably still drop down to 4.2 and down to this level around 3.8 as well, and consolidate from there and perhaps get a second rally. But that is something for the future. So I'd really say it's one of these two scenarios, depending on whether we are able to break above 5.2 and 5.3 again in the next 2 or 3 days. So that's my full take on Anchor. If you do have any questions, let me know. But for now, take care and bye.